March 28, 1964, a military coup happened in Brazil. The coup removed João Goulart, the current president, from power and implemented a military regime. Goulart was suspected of having communist ideals and was not tolerated by the American government. The United States had a direct influence in the coup, and without their support, the coup wouldn't have been carried out.
In the late 1950s and early 1960s, Brazil suffered with great social inequality. Brazil was an extremely rural country and largely dependent on manual labor.
João Goulart, also known as Jango, was born in Rio Grande do Sul. His parents were extremely rich and owned an extensive amount of farming land. In 1958, when his father passed away, Jango became one of the richest people in the state. Jango was elected vice president for Jânio Quadros in 1960. He then became president when Quadros renounced in 1962. Jango was a large supporter of the agrarian reform that would take land from large plantation owners and give to small farmers. Jango was considered to have a communist influence due to his close relations with Fidel Castro and for his political support to the agrarian worker.
The Kennedy administration immediately decided that Jango was not someone they could work with. He was too far left and too pro-Cuba. It was in the Kennedy administration that the US began to act against Jango.
Lincoln Gordon was an American ambassador that lived in Brazil from 1961 to 1966. He was directly and indirectly involved in planning and executing the military. Lincoln Gordon had direct relations with President Kennedy. Many of these interactions were taped. Gordon also wrote letters where he explicitly tries to convince Kennedy that the US had to intervene to overthrow Goulart.
Goulart's attitudes represent a threat to the free world. My personal conclusion is that Goulart and Brazil's recent actions in agrarian land will lead Brazil to a communist government, similar to that of Fidel Castro's in Cuba. Signed, Lincoln Gordon.
João Goulart is accepting the active collaboration of the Brazilian Communist Party and of the Radical Left Revolutionary Syndicalist Union, CGT. Heading the reforms de base is Goulart's leader of the Labour Party, Deputy Bocaiúva Cunha.
If American troops are sent against Fidel Castro, you are going to have the whole country of Brazil. You are going to have the whole country, I say, and I'm not exaggerating. Supporting Fidel Castro.
We want the Brazilian foreign policy to be Brazilian. We want to put the Brazilian interest before everything.
With Kennedy's assassination, Lyndon Johnson simply picked up from where Kennedy left off.
Lyndon Johnson basically says in these tapes that the US just can't take Goulart, that if they need to stick out their heads, then they should. The US at the time was already fully prepared to engage, even with armed forces. There were American troops stationed in Aruba, and from there their orders would be to move on to the ports of Santos and Puerto de Galinhas.
In the meantime, they have drafted an impeachment in congressional circles of Goulart, but there's been no action taken on it, but they've listed all the offenses against the Constitution which they allege. And there's a lot of bickering around to see what could be done, presumably, in the way of forming some kind of a rump civilian government which would have a claim to legitimacy.
I think we ought to take every step that we can, be prepared to do everything that we need to do, just as we were in Panama, if that is at all feasible. We just can't take this one, and I'd get right on top of it and stick my neck out a little.
On March 28, 1964, the Brazilian military troops marched onto Brasilia, the capital of Brazil. Even though Brazil's government changed from a democracy to a military dictatorship, no shots were taken, and no blood was spilled. The Americans never needed to publicly support the military. Jango just decided to let go of power because he knew that we have no chance in a war. Jango escaped and went to Rio Grande do Sul, his home state. From there, he went into Uruguay, where he lived the rest of his life in exile.
Did you advise President Johnson to recognize the new Brazilian government as quickly as he did?
Of course.
In connection specifically with the rapidity with which it was recognized?
Yes. The action that was taken by President Johnson was in response to a specific recommendation we made on late Thursday afternoon, April 2nd.
The U.S. was the first nation to recognize the coup, making a huge mistake that they would regret to this day. By being the first nation to recognize, and doing so only 2 days after the coup, they showed the world that they were an essential player for its success. When these documents were released, their influence became even more evident.
Castelo Branco was the first president of Brazil during the military regime. Through documents that are now uncovered, it's clear that Branco was chosen by the United States to lead Brazil.
General Castelo Branco, Army Chief of Staff, is a highly respected officer, devoted Catholic, and admires the United States' role as a defender of freedom. Signed, Vernon Walters, U.S. Army officer and diplomat.
Que é uma maneira de ser escutado. Esse silêncio todo me atordoa.
Rio de Janeiro has been taken by a democratic rally with crowds suppressing those of the carnival season. I am mostly pleased to say that the elimination of Goulart represents a great victory for the free world. Signed, Lincoln Gordon.
Pai, afasta de mim esse cálice. Pai, afasta de mim esse cálice. De vinho tinto de sangue. De muito gorda a porca já não anda. De muito usada a faca já não corta.
Both songs used in this video, Cálice by Chico Buarque.
Essa palavra presa na garganta. Esse pileque homérico no mundo.
And Caminhando e Cantando by Geraldo Vandré.
Caminhando e cantando e seguindo a canção.
Were written during the military dictatorship. Their message is passed through metaphors to get around the censorship instated during this period.
The United States had an important role in the coup that happened in Brazil, the same way they played a role in the government of other countries throughout South and Central America, such as Panama, Chile, Argentina, Guatemala, El Salvador, and Venezuela. Without the American support, Brazil wouldn't have accomplished the military coup and probably would have fallen to communism.